Not all of the news that we were hoping for to end 2021 with Shadow, but still some good news nonetheless. So let's get started with the Shadow PC news. First off, if you hadn't heard, Halo Infinite is now fixed and working on Shadow PC, despite the issues from the beta versions and the multiplayer. Since the launch of the campaign on December 8th, it is now fully working. This will also be the case for Monster Hunter. Monster Hunter will be fully working from February at launch, although it has had issues in the beta, it is confirmed to be fully running on the full version. Good news for those using or wanting to use Shadow VR, the Oculus Quest official VR app will launch in early 2022. The Shadow beta app is available to test using the sideloading technique, but it will be officially launched in February. For those of you who are interested in running dual screen on Shadow, this is now officially called Remote Screen. This is a feature that will allow you to run two screens on Shadow PC by connecting via two different devices. So you could be connected via your PC and also connect via your iPad or a tablet and get a second screen. This is nearing completion and they are hoping to release this in an update in early 2022. As part of the new update coming early 2022, they are also going to be enabling full hardware decoding for 444. So for those of you who have been waiting for the 444 update, if you have an NVIDIA GPU, you will have the hardware decoding update as part of that as well. Good news for those on Android. Android will finally start getting updates again from January, as they now have a full-time Android developer again, so the authentication and other features will fall in line with iOS. And for those of you that were able to get friends to join on Shadow via the referral program, they're making it simpler to be able to share your code directly from the client. For those of you that were worried about the Amsterdam data center being shut down and everybody moved to Paris, there is a new data center being opened closer to London, which will be Gravelin, and there will also be a new data center opening in Frankfurt. So two new European data centers should help with the load and give better latency for those in the UK especially, and anyone closer to Germany. Now on to the hardware news, and unfortunately this is not the news that everybody was hoping for. Due to the global pandemic, they are no longer able to provide an upgrade path for what is deemed to be the 3070 equivalent at this time. All new tier plans have been put on hold until they can figure out a supply plan. So they were hoping to do this for summer next year, but they are not going to give any definitive dates until there is an actual plan in place. What they have said is that they are looking to give the newer AMD CPUs as well as the 3070 equivalent GPU. They have said that they do not want it to be double the price of the boost tier. They're looking for a happy medium, so it's definitely not going to be twice the price, but you can expect it to be fairly close. They have also stated that there is no plans to update the boost tier at this time, which is a shame. Despite many questions in the chat, they are not looking to upgrade the current boost tier, but what they have said is once the new tier is in place, they'll be looking to rotate the tiers as they are able to get newer hardware in place. So for now, boost will stay as it is. Once the 3070 tier comes into place, after a year or when they can source better hardware, the boost tier will become the 3070 tier and the 3070 tier will be replaced with something much better. So we have heard this before. Let us know in the comments below if you're going to be holding out for that new tier, or whether boost tier is doing the job for you, or whether you've just had enough. That's about it from Shadow at this time. Hopefully in January we'll see these new app updates and we'll get some better news going forwards. Thanks for watching, don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things cloud gaming, and we will see you next time.